Topics covered in this video are principles of training, Reddy's acronym of training, and benefits of training. Let's discuss principles of training. Principle, as we say, Siddhant in Hindi. So these are the basic rules or idea that govern a particular phenomenon. So here we are going to talk about principles of training, which means what are the basic rules that are going to make training an effective process. The first principle is motivation. Now, if the parties involved in training process, that is the trainee and the trainer, are highly motivated, then definitely training program is going to be beneficial for them as well as for the entire organization. Second principle is reinforcement. Now, what is reinforcement? Reinforcement means we are making them do something again and again so that it becomes a permanent part of their behavior. So we are basically making something stronger. Either it can be done in a positive way or it can be done in a negative way. So we have positive reinforcement and negative reinforcement. Positive reinforcement will cover if we are enhancing their salary, we are giving them status, recognition, or any such thing. Negative reinforcement will cover, it may cover a sort of threat, any sort of punishment. So it varies from person to person. Third is practice. So as it is well said that more practice will bear more fruitful results. And the last is individual preferences. So trainer has to adjust the training program as per the individual abilities and aptitude. Reddy's acronym of training. Reddy has defined training where each letter signifies a meaning. So T stands for talent and tenacity. Tenacity means strong determination. R stands for reinforcement. A stands for awareness. I stands for interest. N stands for novelties, that means new things. I stands for intensity. N stands for nurturing. And G stands for grip. Now, what are the benefits of training to the individual? It raises the skill level. It increases the versatility and adaptability of employees. Basically, it eliminates the boredom and monotony. Third is, it eliminates fear in attempting new tasks. It heightens the morale of employees. It increases job satisfaction. And definitely, trained employees are going to be an asset for an organization. Now, how organization is going to be benefited from the training program? First is, it increases productivity and quality of work. Second is, it improves morale, reduces absenteeism and attrition. Attrition is basically employees leaving the organization. So training is definitely going to lower down the rate of attrition. It helps keep costs down in many areas like production, personnel administration. It creates a better corporate image. It helps in conflict handling, thus reduces the stress level of employees. Need for constant supervision is reduced. So if the employees are properly trained, they will be working in an effective manner. So there won't be much need of supervision. It prevents manpower obsolescence. Now, obsolescence means that things which are becoming outdated. So through training, employees will be well aware of the changes. They will just keep themselves updated with the new requirements of the organization. So it is going to prevent that obsolete nature. It matches the employee specifications with the job requirements and organizational commitment. Can we say training acts as a catalyst? Now, what is a catalyst? A catalyst is a substance which speeds up the reaction. In chemistry, everyone of us must have studied about catalyst. So how can we say in HRM that training acts as a catalyst? We can say that training speeds up the reaction of group cohesiveness. Now, what is group cohesiveness? Group cohesiveness means the bonding in group enhances, or the human relations enhances, as it provides a good climate for learning, growth and coordination.